And welcome back to episode 37 of creating this watch in Maya 2018. So today we're going to scale this over to the other side. So let's go into this view, press D and then hold down V and then snap this to the middle right there. And then with object mode selected, duplicate this and I want -1 and scale X. So see how this looks. Yep, perfect. So I wanted it to be. Okay, so now we've done that. We need to start working on the top. And I want to see something. Yep, okay. So I want to know if there is something noticeable in there. So now we need to work on the top. And I think actually before we do that, we'll add this text. So it seems to say Louie right there, which actually also is my cat's name. So I'm going to go over to here and create a new text and call this, whoops, my cat is actually spelled like this, but this is cool too, Louis, and then Adobe Cameron Pro, so we have Louie there, and center the pivot, rotate this -90. Scale it or whatever. Actually, not gonna do that because this scales it already. And bring this down to here, and you can kind of see the text, so we can maybe match that up as well. And look, our font matches that too. So I'm still happy that I found the correct one, because when I make the Rolexes, it's kind of hard to find the correct font. So I think this will match. So if I go to deform. Nonlinear bend, and let's give this a 15 for starters, and rotate this, so let's see, 0 right here, it looks pretty good to me actually, so I might keep it like this. Let's see how a real one looks. Try and find a picture. Here we go. Looks like it's basically like that, and also looks like it's beveled, but I'm pretty sure it's too late. Unless I got rid of the. No, thank God I didn't get rid of that. Okay. Open this up, type 1 geometry, and make sure that you do enable bevel. That way we get that look, which is what I wanted. And then bring. Oh my God. This down to about here. Make it really thin. You don't want it poking out the bottom. And also I'm gonna apply the blend 30, was it? No, I think it was the one that was under that. Blend 29. Yep, there we go. And I'm going to Alt Shift D, delete the history, and see how this looks. We have Louie, and we have Louie, like, perfect. Although, we can do some adjustments into here, some rotations, and that looks pretty good. Okay, I like the way that looks. Now let's do it to the other side. So let's create another text. And the other one says, I'm pretty sure, that word, I think. Let's see what it says here. Moinette, yep, that's the name of the, like, watch right there, the Louis Moinette, and then that right there, I think, is the name, and I think I actually did something wrong, which I really, really hope I didn't do. No, it just seems to be called Meteoroid there. Although, I have a feeling that if I take another look at the watch, it actually says, not that, it says that, and not. Nope, it says Meteoroid, so thank God. That works. So, we're gonna type in what it says here, which is, I'm pretty sure, what it says here, so we can just take that, it's M-O-I-N-E-T, yep, Moinet, so, let's make this Adobe Garmin, that's, and type in, Moinet. Center the pivot, and I'm going to create the, let's see, yep, nope, never mind, and go to geometry, and, whoops, Control-Z, let's gotta do more, yeah, okay, so center that pivot, and bevel that, we're going to take this negative 90, right there, and scale this all the way down to fit our reference here. So, something like this will be good. So let's create a bend, deform, nonlinear bend. I'm going to give this a 15 degree curvature and rotate this. Let's see. What would zero be? The other way. Okay. Type in 180 maybe? Nope. Although I think so, yeah. 180. That should do it. Although, actually, before I'm not going to make that bend yet. Freeze the transformations. And then go to deform. Nonlinear bend. That way the bend is what I want. 15. And I can't even see it. Probably because it's right there. Yep, okay. So I'm going to rotate this. Let's see. Negative 90 on that. 90 on there. And let's see. I'm trying to make this work. In fact, maybe. Trying to see if I can get this to be perfect. So, like, that's pretty good. Let's see how this looks as well. I think we could deal with a bit more curvature. Let's go to 20. Looks good. Do some rotations here. And, yep, so let's do Alt Shift D, delete the history. And take a look. I'm gonna give this the type 29 blend. Scale this down quite a whoops. Scale it down quite a bit. And drop that. So like here. Okay. So let's see how this looks. Compared to a real one. Yep, I like that a lot. Matches perfectly. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.